Franchisee screws up royally. Well, it happened. In Prince George, BC, I had one of my ex-employees father buy a franchise off me, and we opened it up in Prince George, their hometown, I believe. And she got carried away, I guess. Not too sure what was going on, but she turned into a party animal and wouldn't even open up the store. And people were waiting in line for their haircuts, for their photography, for regular business. And all of a sudden, we're on the news. We had spent a fortune putting out a special promotion up there where people could get their pictures done for a great price to get the location going. Anyways, with over 100 people sold and yet nobody could get their glamour photography done at Sharpshooters. So what a problem. So here I am on the news on BCTV, and CKPG up in Prince George saying that Sharpshooters is ripping off people. Well, geez, I gave him a call and put myself on the air right away and said, I'm sending up my A-team, my best hairdresser, my best makeup artist, and of course, myself, the almighty, Mr. Sharpshooter himself. And we told him we're gonna be up between a certain date and a certain date, probably a week, and for people to give us a call and make an appointment, and which hotel would be at. And we turned that negative into a positive. Yeah, we lost the store. Absolutely, I had to close it down. But the great thing was that, boy, did we actually make a lot of money. Because when they heard the A-team was coming up, they ordered pictures galore. So that was I was pretty young, which you'll see in the next segment. Western Living magazine, a reporter, did a surprise story on me, and it went all across Canada and all their Toronto Living, who knows, Montreal Living. I'm not too sure how many livings there are. I believe there was quite a few. So all of a sudden, Live It Up from Toronto, that television show from CTV, they fly out and do a segment on me. Our BCTV does a news article. The Vancouver show, the CKVU, did a fabulous show with Dusty Martel, the hostess. And Ray Corelli from Pacific Report does a documentary on our company. And I gotta say, that was a super professional job. Ray, you're a pro all the way. So I'll put on a couple of segments, maybe three or two. We'll see, and hope you enjoy them.
You know, most of us have our fantasies, and one of the most common is the dream about being rich and famous. Most of us will never make it or even come close. But there is one consolation, and it's available for a modest price right here in Vancouver.
He dropped his hand for a second. That's good. Just like that. I'll turn your head over. Good. Perfect. Right there. I'll just cut you off right from here. Good. Keep your head turned over. Looking in the camera. Great. Look in the camera.
Do you ever dream about being so rich and famous that you get your picture on magazine covers? Well, you don't need to be either. For roughly $50, your dream can become reality.
I had a dream. I had an awesome dream.
They like to look good. They like to have a good time. And they like doing it with other people. But they like the glamour, the excitement. They need excitement. They need playthings.
Daniel Miller is the brains behind a Burnaby company called Sharpshooters, which is doing nicely in the business of fulfilling the fantasies, not of the rich and famous, but of ordinary people.
First off, everybody brings 3 or 4 different outfits. I help them choose the best outfit, the best color to go with the background. Once we've picked that outfit, they go in for makeup. After they have their makeup done, they have their hair done. It's dynasty type style of hairdo, a little fluffy and wild. You feel that Hollywood sensation. The expressions really come up.
Miller once entertained a vague ambition to be an architect, but became a commercial photographer instead. He had been at it for several years when, in the late 1970s, he got the idea for Sharpshooters. The customers think it's great.
They make you look really glamorous, and you look at all the magazine covers all the time, and you figure, hey, if they can look like that, why can't I? And they can do it.
If you had a chance to get your face on the cover of a real magazine, would you do it?
Oh, sure. Why not? Wouldn't you?
Fantasia, Entertainment for Men, sounds like a real magazine. Canadian Centerfold. Appeal, Modern Woman. They look, they have the subtitles like a real magazine. We get people that go all the way out and rent cars and helicopters and models just to get that shot for the cover of Corporate Living, just for the excitement. They know they might not never be there, but it's just something to put on the wall where somebody walk into their office and say, "Wow, congratulations, you know, let me shake your hand, you know."
What you're looking at here and what comes out in the cover is, well, the cover's better, because I just don't take good pictures. So when I have all my friends in, like the rest of us here, it's just excellent. You look at it and say, "What's that?" They look up and they go, "You're on a cover, when did that happen?" And I say, "Well, you know," then you play along.
What did your friends say, particularly, I guess, your partners, when they found out you were doing this? Did you take a lot of ribbing about it?
No, I'm not sure that they still know. They probably know after this. But my friends participated with me, and I think we were all in the right spirit. And a lot of people thought it looked good.
Richard Pearson is a lawyer. Evidence that the conservative professionals are just as susceptible to fantasy as the rest of us. The same applies to people at the other end of the legal spectrum. This guy in the jungle gear is Frank Bouchard, a prison guard and part-time computer products salesman. But what is it that persuades a computer salesman to climb into combat gear and pose for a magazine cover?
Is it like a Jekyll and Hyde?
Just about, yeah. I tell you, they really want to flaunt their stuff. Sort of, you know, like, they're proud, they feel really good. In fact, I've done psychologists before. Psychologists think that what we do for society is really good. We give a boost to people.
When you think about it, Danielle Malaire's success is not really a mystery. If fantasy lacked appeal, then Alice in Wonderland wouldn't have been a bestseller, The Wizard of Oz wouldn't have been a box office hit, and Dynasty would never have made it to television.
I think every girl, you know, when they're growing up, think, oh, it wouldn't be nice to be a model. You know, you're flipping through all the pages of magazines and you see all these beautiful women. It's just a chance to live out a girlhood dream.
Your friends, they say, wow, do you ever look, you know, that's you? And maybe you start to think, well, you know, maybe I do look better at times than I think I do. Maybe you kind of pat yourself on the back.
Not only do the transformations make the subjects look different, some of them work magic.
I didn't even recognize my picture.
Really, eh?
Yeah. When I looked at it, I thought, God, it would be really neat if that was a real magazine, you know, not just a fake one.
Maybe someday it will be, you think?
No.
No?
No.
Illusions don't go that far? Fantasies don't go that far?
Well, I guess if that's not what I want.
Yeah.
I guess if that's what I wanted, I'd go for it, but it's not what I want, so.
What do you want?
I want to be a travel agent.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So it is partly fantasy?
Yeah. I would say so.
Nothing wrong with that?
No, nothing.
Fantasies are some of the best parts of our lives, I guess.
Yes, that's true. What would you do without fantasy?
Photographer Daniel Mallaire, Vancouver dreammaker. He invented these Tupperware parties for the ego last year. You throw a BYOF, that's bring your own fantasy party, and he provides the hairdresser and everything else. Though your guests do have to bring their own clothes and $55.
If you want to show a little bit of shoulder, a little sexier type of look, you know.
Sure.
If you want to put that on, I'll leave the room and...
I guess.
And,
partygoer Lisa Varga, 25, a clerk. Men go to the parties, but it's rare for them to play.
How long have you been doing makeup now?
For 5 years.
5 years, eh? Yeah. You like it?
I love it.
Yeah.
Chrissy Rodriguez, a secretary who wants to be a Playboy cover girl. Mallaire will put her there.
People really want to play out their fantasies and get pampered and go on a cover of a magazine.
And these are the magazine covers. Phonies, every one of them. But when Daniel's finished, they look real, and they're fun.
Big smile.
Great, perfect. Okay, now bring that attaché case a little bit more.
That's
forward.
Pat Lee, a young executive with BC Tel. And this is his fantasy.
First thing they say is that me in that picture? And at first, they're not too sure whether they like it or not.
Tilt your head just a little. Beautiful, looks great.
Hold it.
Sharpshooters. Now here's Dusty Martell to show us how you can get on the cover of your favorite magazine.
From the hairdresser to the makeup artist, it's all done for you. It sounded like a real thrill, so I decided to try it. First, we chose the wardrobe.
Okay, Dusty, why don't you turn around and show me your outfit?
You ready?
Yeah. Let's have a look.
Not much to it.
Wow, looks great. Looks great. Look in the mirror.
Then we did the makeup and the hair.
So do you go along to all the parties, a makeup artist?
I sure do. Yes.
So you're there if we need you.
I have. At all the parties, everyone has their makeup done by us.
Are you supposed to come with no makeup on?
Yeah, it's better.
This was all done in the comfort of a private home. And for hostessing a party, you receive a photo and a frame free. One party, lots of laughs, and $55 later, we were all cover girls on our own magazine. The memories will last forever. If you're ready to be a cover girl or a cover boy, you can give the Sharpshooter team a call at 299-3641. Go ahead, have some fun. Sharpshooters.
You can do it. Sharpshooter parties.
Makeup. Hairstyling.
Sharpshooter parties.
Photography and covers. Do it at a Sharpshooter party.
Sharpshooters.
So you see, keep in touch with your local media. Maybe even your local YouTuber that goes around and looks at what's going on in the community. There's always somebody out there. Get noticed. And if you have a function or something that you're doing special in your business, whether it's in manufacturing or retail, or just a big industry out there, let them know, because it's a free promotion. Don't forget, press subscribe and click on the notification bell. That way I can make some money and you can get notified of all the great tips I'm gonna give you, because I got tons. Enjoy.